Merely 3 minutes after the bomb explosion at the Central Police Station in Kampala, a similar bomb blast exploded at Parliamentary Avenue in between Raja Chambers building, which houses offices of several MPs, and Jubilee Assurance building, where the IGG sits. The massive explosion killed several people, whose sum is yet to be established, injured scores, and set 3 cars ablaze. The blast shattered several buildings and extended to Parliament building, breaking 2 windows. Fear engulfed the city as explosion shattered human flesh on the Parliament Avenue. It took over 30 minutes for ambulances to come to rescue scores of those injured. Civilians struggled to put out fires that gutted parked motor vehicles along Parliament Avenue. It took the brigade over 30 minutes to respond.
I cannot even, a fire extinguisher can't come from CPS.
The Katerera County Member of Parliament, Muhammad Kato, was the first to respond to the scene as everyone fled for their life. He narrated the audio.
As I step on this veranda of this parliamentary fence, something hit behind me. But before that, I had to leave Javas after hearing the bomb. There was a first blast. Then I told my boy sitting within the Java, I said, that is a bomb. Me, let me go. Then I told River, you drive off. Reaching there, I wanted to go to where? To Absa Bank. Then I forgot my check leaf in the car. So I had to follow my driver. As I crossed the parliamentary fence, the thing hit behind me. So I turned like this. As I turned like this, I saw the huge smoke. Now there was a man moving when the whole body is scattered with the meat. The all parts of the body were being scattered from him, but struggling. So I got hold of him, put him on the side.
In his account as an eyewitness, Kato confirms that the attack was done by suicide bombers who perished in the incident.
There is a border stage around the Abusand IPS building. So I think this guy tried maybe to come to the parliament, or he failed, then he went back. So I think he detonated himself from there, because the whole part was shattered completely. There was no head, the head was the other side. All parts of the body were different side.
Parliamentary Avenue and all adjacent roads remained sealed off by joint security agencies throughout the day. Security has been beefed up around Parliament building. The explosions, which happened 3 minutes apart, were carried out by suspected domestic terrorists linked to Allied Democratic Forces using improvised explosive devices, according to police. Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.